We are up on one of the marshes, and there was actually a human being passing by here on the other side there. So the dog was really mesmerized with that. It's a beautiful day again. Lucky us to be alive here and now. So it's been frost for a couple of nights now. We are in mid-October. And I thought we'd just make a short video today from my favorite marshes. And I'll bring you along. A lot of life on the anthill. You can see a couple slowly moving. Oh, actually a few. It's cool for them now. They're probably going to go into, I have to do a twirl, go into, what's that called? Hibernation? Hibernation, is that the right word for ants? Don't know. Pretty soon. I love this. Probably said it before, but I love this. When the grass is yellow. So sparkly. There's a little pond there. Listen to that, when you step on frozen mud and frozen sort of marsh material, it makes that sort of cracking sound. Can you hear that at all? What did you find, Abu? I thought I'd just walk over to this place over here, because it's lovely. Long shadows now. Sorry about the sniffling. Doesn't really matter that I feel my shadow. I was trying to avoid that in the beginning, but well, it's not a problem really. We've come to an area with where there's a lot of water. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to go here or not. I have to check the status of the frozenness of the ground. Seems to be alright. Across over here, maybe. Maybe. So this is a marsh that sort of lets into a small pond over here. That's why it's so wet. I hope the frost on the grass is showing in the video. Because it's very lovely. Oh no, look. I made a sort of hunting tower here. Oh, I hate hunting. Why can't we just leave the wild animals alone? I heard that... I don't know if those numbers are correct, but 98% of all life on this planet is either humans or the animals that we factory farm. And 2% of what's left is wild animals. So it would seem that we could perhaps leave them alone, those 2%. I actually read that in a book. So I couldn't cite the data, but if that's true, it's pretty terrible actually. Here's the pond. Here's the glittering grass. And the dog. Hi, Dobbo. Come and say hello. Dobbo? No. Rago is 9 years old now. So he is a grown-up gentleman. Rago just did a little swim in the outlet from that little pond. He thought we were going to cross and then he jumped right into. But it was not really anywhere for us to cross there, so we are zigzagging through the forest instead. Hey, we are back on the marsh, back on track. So I thought I'd end the video here by the little river, or maybe not a river, more like a little brook, I suppose. I don't know if you can see it, but there's a thin, thin layer of ice, sort of crisscrossed by grass. Rago, I left Rago over there and he's not happy with that. So that's why he makes sounds. There's a bridge here. Hi buddy. You're getting impatient? It's okay. Say goodbye. Goodbye.